I was a resident in neurosurgery, and I was at Duke University, and I did an operation on a patient with one of my attendings called deep brain stimulation. And the next day, I was on my rounds, as residents are, and going into rooms and seeing how people are, and I walked into this gentleman's room, and he was crying. And at first, I was really concerned, because I was like, why is this patient crying? And he looked at me, and I asked him, you know, Mr. So-and-so, why are you crying? And he said, well, you know, I just wrote the first letter I've written my granddaughter in 10 years. Because he had something called essential tremor. And essential tremor is a disease in which the harder you try to do something, the more your hand shakes. And so he wasn't able to write a letter to his granddaughter. And all of a sudden, after this operation, he was able to. Well, that really struck a chord, and I ended up a functional neurosurgeon who does deep brain stimulation. After I finished my residency, I was looking for a place that was going to be able to combine all of my research interests with all of my clinical interests. And so I looked at various fancy places on the East Coast and got a couple of really nice offers, actually. And I was thinking hard about them, and then I heard about a job at the University of Michigan. Well, it turns out that when my parents came from India in 1959, they moved to Ann Arbor. So I was naturally disposed towards Ann Arbor. But what I realized when I came to Michigan is there was this vast university and a wonderful medical center where you could combine work with people across the university, with people in the medical center, and a group of people who really got along well. Add that with 12 neurosurgeons who I genuinely like, and the answer was obvious. Michigan was the place for me.